Welcome back, everyone. My name is Echo. Welcome to part two of season two of the Minecraft Story Mode. If you missed part one, let's just do a little bit of a recap. It's kind of the reintroduction of everyone, but what I've noticed is everyone's so busy doing their own thing. It's only at this current point, Jesse and Petra, who are kind of up for the adventure. Olivia and Axel, they're kind of like, I'm done with that. We're moving on. But at this current point, as you've seen at the end of part one, we're currently chasing something. Petra won't tell Jesse, but there is something in the mine that we kind of have to catch up with. So if you do enjoy this, be sure to hit that like button. And at 1,000 likes, I will bring you the next part. So let's go.
Ha! Woo! All right, where'd you go?
Where'd what go?
Ha! Look down there!
So you're really not gonna tell me what we're chasing?
Nope. The mystery is what makes it fun. Come on!
I love this. It sounds like Chewbacca. No, we definitely... Okay, we did. Didn't think it was gonna make it then. Zombies. Here we go, straight into this. I'm enjoying this adventure.
Look out! Wall spiders!
I see them.
Oh! Get them! Wrecked. He's coming for you, Jesse. Oh, I didn't mean to put... Okay, there we go. I know he went into lava then. How do we do this? Oh! Goodbye. Spiders can jump.
There! It went into that cave!
It's so fast.
And Petra's in the home stretch! These guys.
Help Petra win the race. I'm winning this race.
What? But you.
Sure, you're not rusty.
I think that maybe you're the rusty one here.
I'll remember this next time you need help.
Oh, really? Ooh, parkour like a boss. Okay, that was fun.
Man, you're faster than I remember. You were so supposed to
I'm just
lose.
Better, that's all. You are awesome.
Everybody
I still
knows
got
I'm
it.
Faster than you.
I still
hey,
got
I'm
it.
Surprised as you are. I'm just glad I've still got it.
Guess I didn't have anything to worry about after all.
Okay, this mystery better live up to all the hype. Here I come, mystery monster.
Sounds so freaky.
Gonna be so happy to see you.
Wait, let me get this straight. This quest was just to track down a stupid llama?
I love it already. I love it already.
It's not just a stupid llama. It's important, okay? It's apparently like a treasure sniffing llama, or it's important, okay? Please, just trust me. We just need to bring her back to her owner.
Okay, I trust you.
Okay,
a
okay,
treasure
I'm sorry.
Sniffing
if you say it's important,
llama.
Then I trust you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, how about we get you out of here, huh?
Make smoochy noises. Come to Jesse.
All right. Hey there, llama. Come here, girl. Good llama.
Oh!
That's what you get for wearing that dork armor.
Yeah. I'll just have to craft a new set. Dang.
Let's get this thing. Don't let it get away.
Okay, ready?
Just grab the...
I love this llama. He's so amazing. He's like, hey, get out of here. Oh, no way.
Oh, gross.
I love it.
Come on, let's get after that armor wrecking thing.
That is amazing. Well,
hang on, it's super dark down there. We should make a torch.
Okay, here we go. Let's get this llama. Okay, let's stick and torch and create.
Here, llama.
I wish you could do that in Minecraft. Hold the torches.
After you, Mayor Jesse.
Told you, I'm not the mayor. I'm the...
Leader and hero in residence. I know. It's just that you do a lot of paperwork and, like, town running things. Call a shovel, am I right?
I'll see you.
How the heck did you get up there?
Who knows, but it's coming down now.
Ah. Uh-oh. One more and he's gonna escape.
What the?
Okay.
Oh, get out of the way. I was looking at that.
Jesse Ray doesn't like this llama, but I love it.
One way to find out.
Okay, here we go. Up we go.
What was that creepy whisper?
I didn't hear anything.
Ah, so it's only Jesse who can hear this.
Whoa, girl. What is it?
Some sort of glove or gauntlet? Looks like it's made out of prismarine.
A prismarine? But you only find that at the bottom of the ocean.
Glove, pick it up. Okay. Oh snap.
Whoa!
What is this thing?
I don't know. It seems like it's not hurting you, and that's good.
Sure.
It looks kind of...
Maybe it has powers.
It keeps whispering to me.
I'm freaking out here.
Gotta tell you, I am freaking out here.
It's gonna be okay. It'll be okay. We'll figure it out. Well, here. I'll help you take it off.
It's not gonna work.
Okay. Ow. Wow. Stop.
That thing is really stuck. I just can't shake this feeling that maybe you were meant to find that gauntlet. Like, maybe it was your destiny.
Maybe I was.
Yeah, maybe it was down here waiting for me.
Okay, that's just unsettling.
Uh-oh, get off the pyramid, quick!
Uh-oh, go. Oh.
Come on, let's get you up out of there.
Yeah, help me, Petra. I don't want to die.
Now what the heck is that thing? It's like a huge mouth in the ground?
Some sort of heck mouth?
New
sure,
portal.
Yeah, heck mouth.
I don't think I can see the bottom. Ugh, it gives me the willies.
We need to cover it now.
What's that sound coming from down there?
I don't care whether we can see the bottom or not. We need to cover it up now.
Right.
Not sure. sure, but I'm getting a bad feeling that it's the actual way we're going to fix this. On second thought, let's talk about it anywhere but here.
Not getting out the way we came, though.
Why? You can move gravel. Ah, hole.
There, come on.
Come on, llama. Okay, well, they didn't take the llama, so now we're llama-less. This is interesting, though. It's a very interesting start. Because Jesse was the only one who could hear it. There we go.
Oh, it's so close to Beacon Town.
Here, maybe you could leave a warning or something?
Warning, Heckmouth, keep it off the grass. Top secret, go away. Nothing to see here. See, when you say top secret, go away, people be like, what's down there? Keep off the grass kind of seems likely. Warning, Heckmouth, people get interested, nothing. So we go keep off the grass. Because I feel like if people keep off the grass, it's like, okay. They probably won't, but still. Keep off the grass. Yeah, kind of makes sense.
Sure. Yeah, that works.
Okay, then. What do we do about all this?
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
Well, it's all made of prismarine, right? And you only find that in, like, monuments and stuff at the bottom of the ocean. There's a treasure hunter in Beacon Town named Jack. Kind of a legend. He knows everything about prismarine, exploring the ocean. Because we definitely can't have
I can't wait to
that
meet him. Sounds kind of weird. Yet. Dude, trust
was,
him. Just let's
really
meet
bad.
Him.
That sounds perfect. I can't wait to meet this guy.
Knew you'd be excited. Yes. And I'll take you to Jack's shop as soon as I'm back. But first, I really need to deal with this llama.
What about me?
Okay. Come on, you.
What about my hand? This thing won't come off.
I know. But this llama...
Why is that llama so important to you?
You know my sword? Gold one, with all the enchantments?
Miss Butter?
Yeah, I kinda got tricked by this person named Stella. Said she just wanted to put it on display for a little while. And now she won't give it back until I do dumb quests like this for her.
That's so unfair. Wow, how humiliating.
Not great.
Wow. Can't believe you're getting pushed around like that. That's kinda...
Humiliating? Yeah, I know. So, yeah, her name's Stella, and she's kind of obsessed with treasure. She says this is her treasure-sniffing llama, her... She runs a place called Champion City.
Wait, like, Champion City right over there? I had no idea their leader was like that.
Yeah, she's ambitious, and she's willing to do anything to get her way. Bullying, lying, cheating. Without my sword, I just really need to get it back. Just hope Stella.
You really need my help? I hate bullies.
I can smell a bully from a mile away, Petra, and I don't let bullies go being smelled on my watch.
You're one of the good ones, Jesse. Thanks.
Come on. Can't wait to meet this Stella myself.
Yeah. Okay. Let's do it.
Then, freshly rearmed, we'll come back, sort out that heck mouth, and get this thing off my hand.
Okay. So we found a bully, and that's Stella. Now, I remember her from the trailer, so she doesn't seem like a nice person. So, we're about to see what this is gonna be about. New town, new city, new place, new llama. I want to keep the llama, though. It's a llama Pixelot.
This is it. Champion City. Every single
very
one of those
impressive
apartments up
more
there
like Llama
is
City.
Exactly the same.
If it's really Champion City, then where are all the champions, huh? It's more like Llama City.
Yeah, good one.
The llama's not impressed.
What? Come on, we're almost there. It's like she doesn't want to go see Stella. I kind of know how she feels. Just really
Stella
need this
can't
to
be
go
that off. Are you scared?
And with Stella, well, it doesn't most times.
Petra, you're not scared of her, are you?
What? No, she's just... She's really manipulative, all right? Anyway, Stella usually has her office hours in the center of the courtyard.
Well, I hope she's ready for an appointment with Jesse and Petra.
Let's do this. Let's have a quick look at the llama, because I do like the pixel arts. Because I'm terrible at pixel art, so I love seeing them.
Stella person sure likes her llamas.
You might say she likes them better than people.
I love that the fact that he was smiling. Main entrance. Have a quick look at this. See if we notice anything different. Minecarts. Ah!
Wow, that is a classy mineshaft entrance. Didn't know they could look that nice.
Huh, yeah. Nothing's allowed in Champion City that doesn't look nice. Stella makes sure of it.
Okay then, well, we can't go in there. I wish we could talk to some of the people and see if they're nice or not, because you'll know from talking to people if they're nice or not in that city, because the Beacon Town people, they're... Yeah, here we go. Talk to the gardener. Let's have a quick talk to the gardener. Very different.
Wow, even the flowers are organized.
Yeah, and see the gardeners working on them? They all owe her stuff, too. Everyone in town owes Stella something. I think that's where she got most of the materials
the whole
to build
town?
Champion City in the first place.
Wait, the whole town? How?
Yep. She's always finding little reasons that people's trades aren't enough, making up rules.
Well, your sword is one trade Stella won't be getting out of. I'm gonna make sure of it.
Thanks, Jesse. You're a real pal. Okay, let's... Wait, Petra and Llama, let's have a quick talk to these.
Hey, the Llama doing okay?
Hard to tell. She seems really nervous. We should probably get her to Stella as soon as you're done looking around.
All right, let's go now then. Let's go. Let's see what this Stella's all about, because she didn't sound like a nice person. Hello? Aha, here she is. Okay. She had a wolf.
That's right. Puppies for everyone. No shoving now. We're not Beacon Towners.
You probably put this together right now, but Stella's pretty fond of herself. I would play to her ego.
Oh, well, that is a cute one. And he could be all
yours.
Yeah,
let's go through.
Provided
you
have
my way.
Payment, of course.
We gotta talk to this Stella and see what this is all about.
Your outfit wonderfully.
She's a businesswoman, you can already tell.
Come on, you.
Oh, Luna, my darling. You came home. You came back.
Do it. Spit
Rodrigo,
at her.
Could you bring Luna home, please?
I feel so mean now.
There's a good girl.
Stella.
Oh, look who it is. Jesse, leader of Beacon Town, and my sworn rival.
I've never met her before, right?
No.
Our rivalry, Beacon Town versus Champion City? Surely you think about it as much as I do?
Oh, boy.
Sorry, but you are not my rival. Even my B-list villains are way scarier than you.
Oh, snap!
I don't know what kind of mind games you are trying to bring into our rivalry, but I'll tell you right now, they are not going to work on me. I love the glove, by the way. Absolutely, darling. You wouldn't be interested in trading, would you?
I knew it.
Got some fine puppies here.
You can't take it off.
All free range, of course.
I can't take off the glove. That's a terrible trade. Don't change this. We can't
oh,
take it off.
I really, really wish I could. I mean, really, but I can't.
Oh, too bad. They're very cute puppies. And, you know, I heard you need a new pet, so...
That's so mean.
Okay, hold it.
Oh, Petra, you're here too. I almost thought Luna just came back on her own. What do I owe you? A puppy?
No, that wasn't...
A diamond, maybe?
Stop changing the deal.
An emerald. Don't push too hard, Nell.
Stop changing the deal around, Stella. It's wrong.
Well, I never. The deal hasn't, you know, changed.
Sword. I want sword. My sword.
I was very clear. I make trades for treasures.
I think I'm all done here.
You said you just wanted to display it. I thought I could still use it.
Oh, no, honey, no. You wanted to become my champion. You came to me, remember? In exchange, you got to live here instead of Beacontown. Isn't that nice? Oh, no, was that supposed to be a secret?
When were you going to tell me?
When exactly were you going to tell me about this?
Soon, I swear.
Well, I think it's about time I go back to my treasure hall, Jesse. By the way, way nicer than yours.
I don't like this person already. But I don't like what Petra just done. That's so...
Did you know the way out? Of what am I saying? Of course Petra does.
That's
if
so cheap.
If you ever want to place in Champion City, just ask.
Like I said, she's the worst.
She won't get away with this. You live in her town.
Hey, you're the one who decided to live here.
Yeah, I deserve that. But can we please wait till we're out of town to talk about it? Right now, I really need to figure out how I'm going to get my sword back. I just don't know how we're going to do that. Stella's treasure room is right there. But I've got a bad feeling about those bodyguards of hers. Could probably sneak in through the puppy kennel, but that's a lot of barking puppies.
There's got to be a way.
All right, we're going to end part two right there. You know what, guys? I don't like what Petra done. That was very, very cheap, and she lied. So she got Jesse to help her get the llama, didn't explain it to her, but this whole time, she's been moving to Champion Town? The Champion City? I don't know why she would want to do that. I don't know what's going on in Petra's head, but we got to figure out how to get her sword back. We still got to figure out what's going on with Jesse's glove, because it's still calling him. So I got a feeling that the next part might be a little bit more adventurous. If you do want to see that, hit the like button, and I'll catch you in part 3.